computing, computers, technology, everything around us has been invented to solve problems. It's not to build a better flash card. And in essence, what we're doing is we're teaching our students to be hackers in its purest definition.
We've gone through a school system so many times where, like, here's the answer, here's the experiment that you do, and then make sure that you got it right. That's not true when you're doing anything in the real world. Hey, I'm Melanie Shimano, and I run the food computer program in Baltimore, Maryland.
Hi, Melanie. I'm Charlie Reisinger. I'm the Director of Technology for Penn Manor School District in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania. As educators, our job is to give our students or expose our students to the widest range of ideas and skills and modes of thinking, to teach them how to think critically, how to problem solve, and ultimately give them the agency to decide what interests them, what motivates them, what they're passionate about, and what they would like to pursue, you know, potentially as a lifelong endeavor or as a career.
When we talk about education, we talk about, you know, the curriculum. I think education is more about, like, how do we become, you know, who we are, and how do we contribute that and you make that useful for ourselves and for our communities? What's important for the future, and how do you continue to think about what's important for the future and not get stuck in what's been done before?
I like to think that, you know, that self-discovery, it maybe expresses itself more like freeform jazz, where you have, you know, a team of individuals that are working together in that social setting, listening to each other and kind of riffing off of each other's work. And what comes out of that amazing cacophony is, you know, a brilliant work that could never be done if everybody was singing in lockstep.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that totally aligns with, and maybe you think this also, of how open source is in general. I think open source and education are you know, not two totally different things. They maybe are the same thing, right? Same mentality, at least, in terms of you can't do stuff on your own. You can't have, like, an impact on your own. And especially as we're facing, like, big challenges like climate change or whatever, like, you need to think about how we think of these problems collectively and how we solve them collectively. You know, why should people have to reinvent the wheel every time they're doing stuff?
We've created these systems that sort of beats curiosity out of our kids. You know, I have to do the right thing to make sure that I get the right SAT score to get into the right school, right? And it just sort of, there's not a lot of room for curiosity. I think that open source tools, technologies, communities, software, development, the entire concept of open source is a methodology to rekindle that curiosity.
If we can, you know, think about Baltimore as a city, what space do we have available? Students understand what's happening in the city, and then putting all those things together, they say, like, we have access to one of the rooms in the basement that no one is using, and so we're gonna build a hydroponic computer-controlled farm in there. And then think about, like, what does this mean for our school? What does this mean for the immediate community? What does this mean for what you students are interested in general? And how can you build on that and continue to maybe, like, have that in the back of your mind as you're going through stuff, regardless of whether, you know, you become a computer programmer or not?
What we're both doing is we're putting down those little breadcrumbs, or actually more so than breadcrumbs, right? You know, I don't know, little power-ups, you know, for our students that down the road someday they can say, oh, I remember when I worked on the food computer and I did this, and maybe now that'll help me build a better rocket, you know, or be a better doctor, for example. So yeah, I think that liberal arts, you know, kind of philosophy is important. But one young lady comes up to me, fourth grade student. She comes up to me and she's showing me how she has made, you know, objects, you know, this and the scratch cat, essentially just create a big circle. She said oftentimes her older brothers and sisters pick on her, and now she knows how to do something on the computer that they do not. Like, she suddenly had a superpower that the rest of her family did not, that she had command and control over a computer, over technology. I hope if we did our job well, she will remember that moment 20, 30, 40 years from now, and she will never remember the worksheets that she did, right, in her classes. So I think that's the goal, create these powerful experiences, through technology that kids will remember for the rest of their lives.